really upset if someone else actually did it.
You're going.
You're alive.
I just push it better.
It's a better angle.
Look.
Take a look. Take a look at the angle.
It's very faint. I think it's very, very dim.
I can't. I really can't see anything.
No, you can't see stuff. It's not.
Kind of look. You can see. See?
Yeah. Should I zoom in or do you like the stream under it?
Oh, I zoomed in too far. Darn it.
Yeah, I'll just zoom out all the way. Yeah, Andrew, you like this one?
I guess so. Let's see.
I have a baseball game over there. I like watching baseball games. They're pretty nice.
There you go, that's about it.
Hopefully both of them work.
Let's go.
Andrew, do you like this angle? As you can see, like, some of the stream under it.
Why is everything flickering? Backlight flashing, all that stuff flashing. Why is that still flashing?
No, it's just auto. That's probably why.
I think I like the top down look better if you want to try that.
Well, here I have this angle almost. I feel like it's so much more realistic.
At least 2 feet taller.
Yeah.
Jimmy something after me, but he told me no after, you're too late. After you got the going. And I took that very personally, you know? Like, you exclude me, but you let Jackass go. And I take that extremely personally. You know? So I cut his class, because I happened to realize that I'm not doing this anymore. I'm not staying here. Everybody's looking at me funny, because I'm the odd man and I'm staying here. I'm not doing this. Come drag me down by the back, by the hair of my neck.
So I am having such a bad day, and to have this, this was the last straw. I'm broken, okay? I'm absolutely heartbroken. Absolutely heartbroken.
starts it.
Okay.
It's remote? No. He has the information.
Yeah. Hello everyone, welcome to Tripping on Nature. This week we're tripping in temperate rainforest. Is it?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Oh, certainly.
Wait, tell him here. I'll tell you exactly where it needs to go.
Move on.
Okay, that camera doesn't help us. The zip tie is blocking my view of you. Move your chair up a little bit.
Where's the drawer?
I don't know what to move.
All right, well then.
That's better, okay.
I'll put the photo frame here.
Where's the audio coming from?
No, but then I won't be able to see it. It'll make no sense.
I'm just going
to
use a microphone now. And if it's like, if the volume is too low, we'll just enhance it.
Just like. Somebody can turn it around with the time.
Is my camera actually recording stuff?
So to answer your question about the key to this, you might put it on the end of the desk, kind of facing me.
Yeah.
And then, should it come up, you can move it around for the camera. When you're talking about it, you can reach over and go, you know, show it more to the camera. You can put it wherever you think is best.
That looks a little more natural than before, so my vote is to get to go. I'm also gonna check before I show up in this video, but make sure everything's still recording.
Is mine still recording?
Yes.
Wow.
You've gone down over 10% in 10 minutes.
What?
You're going dead.
Still got some light?
Is it still in the 90s?
Yeah. Almost in the 80s.
That's fine.
So I meant the headless.
Sony battery. Hello and welcome to Tripping on Nature. This week we're tripping in the temperate rainforest. Lights aren't on?
Now you just said that. Let me start over. He's like, no, flicker them after you say that.
Are they on?
Yeah, now they're on.
I'll just look at them when I introduce you.
I think I flicker it. So what's that?
Just look at
them. When it makes sense, like, they usually do something, like, they do something at the very beginning when they start the show.
You can't.
So that's no lights for show. Up is on, down is off. No, I would focus on just moving along.
Yeah.
Alright, so this play two and three. You want us to go again? Oh, yeah, we need that book right there.
Jeez.
The little notebook?
Sure. Struggles for me.
Whoa.
Is that good? Just leave it there.
Yeah.
Hello, and welcome to we're tripping on nature. This week we're tripping in the temperate rainforest. We didn't have the budget to go to an actual temperate rainforest, so we're in the deciduous rainforest. This week we have an actual expert of the temperate rainforest. Here he is, Andrew Wagstaff.
Nope, it's too late to wet my feet.
Yeah. Hey Andrew, how are you doing? How you doing?
Okay.
You want some water?
Water?
Here. Here you go. Bad, try it.
Wow, I can taste the insects.
Okay, now tell me about some of the animals that depend on this water for survival.
Well, there are the puma. They're the puma. They're wild pumas. Definitely don't want to meet one of those. And there are, on a much cuter note, there are the tree frogs, Pacific tree frogs.
What type of plants depend on this water?
Well, they're coniferous trees, and there are also mushrooms, many, many types of mushrooms, which we'll come back to.
Can you tell me about how these species have adapted?
Well, mosses are, mosses in particular particularly have adapted to grow on top of other plants instead of to get farther off the ground, because there's very little light in the rainforest due to the thick, dense canopy of leaves formed by the trees. So what little light that comes through is very essential. So therefore, the mosses grow on top of other things. They're closer and aren't blocked by as many.
I've also heard that 50% of the species live in rainforests.
Yes, but I believe a little bit more than half of that are in tropical rainforests.
Much of them are still undiscovered though, correct?
Yes.
In fact, we've got cameramen.
How much we don't know.
Okay. We've got cameramen in locations that have never been explored before. Let's see what they see. So that's like the end of the first segment.
Good. Good.
Could we redo that or is that okay?
No. I mean, you could, but I wouldn't. How many segments do you have? Three, four?
Three.
So I would get through all three and see how you feel about it.
Okay.
What are the other sections?
Mm-hmm.
What are the other sections? I would give that like a B, and he's obviously going to edit it some. The content was good, and Andrew certainly has that star quality about it.
Yeah. And we didn't look at the lights though.
Something. You're a natural.
We didn't talk about Largo either.
Well,
we spent all the time taping Largo.
Can't we come back to him? Is he inscripted?
Yeah, here's supposed to be the introduction.
Let's do the second segment, then we can really do the first part after.
What's the second segment? Like, I don't even know the information.
It's quite funny, so we're supposed to walk through the world.
That's going to get a lot of chuckles, so that's good that you have it there. It's, you know, you've been and also, right, fellas, you can either talk about it or not. You know, you can come back to him in the next
this segment the next year.
Oh.
You can work it in as it's
stuff flowing my cup.
Probably bugs.
Alright.
It's shiny. It's not bugs.
So it's not aluminum. Excuse me, Andrew, are you here on the script for this segment?
I'm gonna say we have some more questions to ask you, but instead of sitting here and asking you boring questions, we're gonna walk through the river and ask you these questions. It's a segment we call Wet Facts.
How are you gonna film that?
We're gonna walk through the river and just get a camera.
Do you have any more the third segment here while you're here? Can you finish up on here?
Yeah.
The walk through the river theoretically could be done.
Yeah, we'll do that some other day. Yeah.
But we wanted to get everything. This isn't going to be here tomorrow.
Yeah, we want to get the talk show part.
Wow, bike boys coming back.
Yeah, we need to get this part, like the part that requires this done.
Let's see what's filming.
What?
Let's see what's filming.
Hopefully, both of them are.
Yep, you're at 70.
Go.
Turn the lights on for a second. I want to see what it looks like.
It looks good. I can see it from the reflection here is awesome. On a 1 to 10, that's a 10 reflection. You can't see it off the brain right here.
Oh, no, again, on. You're kidding me.
What?
There's a section that's out?
No, the camera doesn't pick up the reflection.
Well, the positions of these cameras.
Andrew, I see them now.
No, that's bad. Good. Get up there and do the next segment, please.
We'll redo the first segment after if you want me to. Is this part?
That's good. That's really good. That's good. That's good. That's good.
I've only seen Volkswagen these things.
I haven't
seen another car with under lights. Only two Volkswagens. Yours and some guy in the way.
Alright, you ready?
Yeah. It's kind of cold.
You trying to have a budget for one hot chocolate.
Said we had a budget being a rainforest. Yeah. Three. Okay, and welcome back to Trippin' on Nature. Instead of asking more boring questions to Andrew, we're going to walk through the river and do it there.
Don't
this
worry,
is a segment we call Wet Facts. What? Oh, yeah.
Yes, we forgot that part.
We're going to act like we're distressed.
Yeah, forgot that.
Okay, I'm going to put my head down. We can do that in the start. We can do that in the start. After I flip it around, some guy over there, or you ask, who's that good?
You just look at me when you want me to say that. If you do that, I was just being joking around. You may not want that.
The camera's not going to pick it up much. It's directional mic.
It's
okay,
going to
be
so
the story.
Let's take a moment for the cameraman.
Okay.
Okay, welcome back to Tripping on Nature. So we're going to have more questions to ask for Andrew, but instead of just asking them in this boring location...
Let's take a hike.
Yeah, this is a segment we call Wet Facts. So that's dumb.
Okay.
What are we going to ask now?
Okay. I think the blooper should be longer than the video.
Lights are off now. Let's do the welcome back. Well, that was interesting, Andrew.
Yes, I suppose it was, wasn't it?
Well, we know humans have had a terrible effect on this biome. How have humans lived in this region before? I've heard that the Cherokee have lived here before, right?
So have I. I've heard the same thing. Never actually seen them.
Yeah, they were driven out by the Americans.
Well, that would explain it, wouldn't it?
Yeah. You know what type of adaptations they made to survive here? they live near the river. And, man, if that's what they do. Let's say what the humans
survive.
Yeah, they live near the river. They fished and used the river to farm. Kind of say that.
A problem that you're telling me how it works.
And they built huts.
All right, that sounds good.
You're the expert.
You got that, Andrew?
No, but I don't. What was it?
So they live near the river so that they could farm and fish, and then they built huts too.
So they live near the river for irrigation purposes and irrigation and fish.
Yeah, and farming.
Irrigation for the water.
Yeah, irrigation for farming,
good.
Right? Good. Don't cut yourself on the muffler next to you, the tailpipe on your right side. Tailpipe.
Okay. Let's go.
Big on the ground. Welcome back.
Not yet. I'm just turning the lights on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, welcome back. Andrew, that was some interesting stuff.
Yeah, real exhausting.
Yeah, it was. My feet are all wet and muddy.
My feet are? No.
So I've heard the Cherokee used to live here.
Yes,
is that true? Yeah. How did they survive in this region, in this tough environment?
Well, they start with the basics. They lived on the rivers, but nearby. So they could use they could irrigate for farming, for the water, and to fish.
Where have they gone now?
They've been driven out.
By the Americans. Okay. How have humans affected this environment?
Well, there's a large logging industry for the valuable woods, because in temperate rainforests there are a few types of valuable wood produced. And the loggers cut down old growth forests, which take hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years to grow, and replant them with only one type of tree. The problem with that is that they then go back 4 years later and cut that tree down. But the bigger problem is, yes, there is a bigger problem, believe it or not, the bigger problem is that they replant only one type of tree, which will not support the native species, thus leading to their extinction potential.
That is awful. In fact, we've got a cameraman who has found a logger. Let's see what happens. And then we come back, right? And then I ask you if I can
hang on to the video, make it dark, you know? Yeah. So after the camera clean or whatever.
Is there another segment to film at the desk, or?
Yeah, there's this last little few questions.
Does anyone need a little brush up on this segment?
I'm just gonna ask you,
do we even have all the facts? No. Right?
Yeah, we're gonna do those, the ones that,
So the facts you don't have, we're just gonna spit out while we walk through the water?
Yeah. And do that then.
We should get a walking camera so we can drop it.
How's the summer walking through the water with no boots?
It's kind of cold today.
I don't think we're going to do that today. I don't think we're going to do that today.
You think it's kind of cold?
We're just going to transition and do that
some other day. Absolutely
shaking
a little bit.
Yeah, me too.
So cold. I offered you a jacket.
It's fine.
I look good. I look so good.
You
don't have
to deny that. You make up the lighting, it's all.
Yeah.
Listen, do you want to check the cameras in while we're just thinking about it?
I'm gonna have to wear human protection and all that.
I need to wear 3 layers of socks next time.
Is it on?
Yeah.
How about mine? If it's on, I'm gonna be so happy.
How do you?
Huh?
How do you make the display come on?
Click the power button.
But is that gonna make it?
Not the power button, just this thing.
Oh, this thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, come check this.
Okay.
It seems to be done.
Oh, that's not good.
My camera's still going.
Is it supposed to be 4 minutes long?
It's 5 minutes, and then we won't need a poster.
7 minutes, by the way, no poster.
Not five.
No. 5 to 7. 7. Plus, we have the whole mushroom segment we never got back to.
Why is it like that? Did it record the whole time?
How long is the video? Does anybody tell?
I have no clue.
It's not seeing the water.
Yeah.
Which is so cold.
77% action.
No, don't move the tripod.
You're leaning on a tripod.
It's surprised it lasted that long. Compared to
plastic tripod.
After this, I'm just going to ask you the human protection problem, and I think we'll do the first segment again. And then we'll be done.
I think you're just going to have to go back through, like, just about, like, you know, every 100th, every 10th frame. Like that.
I really don't know how to use this, like, really good.
Why are we using it?
Is it? We adjusted for so long.
Hey, are these blown away?
What blew away?
Oh man, look how my boots have just made this. Look at this. Says I mean a low spot over there, so water runs through the mud.
Let's film the last part and whatever it's like that makes that go. I think we need to film the first one and the second part. Drop the hot chocolate on it. Why? Because you're too clean.